Today, I'll walk you through how to create a 301 redirect for your WordPress website, and we'll cover a few different methods so you can pick the one that works best for you. Hey there, I'm Christina with WP Beginner, where we talk all about WordPress so you can grow your website and reach your audience. If you find value in this video, give it a like. It really does help out. And all the links I talk about, you can find them in the description below. So let's get started. And note, I'll cover a few different methods. So when you find the one that works best for you, then you can stick with that one. So what is a 301 redirect and why do you even need to do that? Well, 301 redirect is basically you telling the reader's browser that they need to go to a new web address on your website. And it's very similar to how when you move, you send your information to the post office so that they can forward or redirect your mail to your new location. It's very similar. You have an old, outdated web address or a link or a page or a post that no longer is active, and you want to forward that on to the new one. So why would you set up a 301 redirect rather than just letting it be a dead link? Well, the biggest reason is if somebody came onto your site and they found that link, it was probably in search results somewhere. So it's ranking. And you don't want to lose that rankings. So you want to be able to funnel that ranking and funnel that traffic to the new one. The other reason is if someone lands on that dead link, they're not going to go on your site and search on your site for that information. They're usually going to go back to Google, start all over and find another website that's sending the information to them that they want. So those are the biggest reasons why you want to set this up. It's a cleaner experience for the user. So the user experience is much greater and Google will like that a lot better. So it helps with your rankings. It doesn't let them tank. It's just an overall better experience for them. And there are several different types of redirects. There are different numbers. For instance, you have a 301 redirect. This is a permanent redirection, meaning that link will never come back and they just need to go to the new one. You also have a 302 redirect, which is like, this is a temporary thing. So it might come back at it later. And then you have 307 and a few others. Those are very technical SEO type things and something that we don't really have to worry about. But just in case you're wondering, why is it called a 301? That's the biggest reason. So the majority of the things we're going to focus on is assuming that your old link is broken and it's a permanent redirection. And that's why we'll be doing 301 redirect idea. Okay, now we've got all that out of the way and hopefully you understand a lot more about this part of SEO. You can find the playlist in the description below where I cover what is SEO, how to do on-page SEO, off-page SEOs, and so much more. You can find that in the description below. But for this, we're just doing a simple redirect for you. Okay, so the first method we're going to use is by using a plugin. And the plugin we're going to use is All-in-One SEO. This is a fantastic SEO plugin for your site. This helps you with search engine optimization. And it helps you with schema markup and so many other things. We won't cover the installation process on this one. I've covered it in detail on installation and configuration. If you want to check out the link in the description below, or I'll have it up here as well. Basically, it just does a lot of handholding and showing you exactly what to do with your site to improve the SEO. It even has SEO scores for you and everything. One of the additional features that it has is it allows you to do redirect. So if you already have it on your site doing other SEO type things with the schema markup and video schema and things like that, then you could also just use the 301 redirect. Now it is a premium plugin. So you'll want to head to All-in-One SEO, and we'll have a link in the description below if you want to just click on that or go to AIO SEO. And make sure you use promo code WPBVIP so you'll get the best discount on it. Once you install it and go through the video, then you can come over to All-in-One SEO. And from here, we have redirect. Now, if you haven't enabled it yet, then you'll just simply want to activate the redirect here. And then once you activate it, then we can go to settings to configure it even further. Now under redirect settings, you have the option to choose PHP or web server. For most people, you can do PHP, that's fine. You can also set up web server. It requires you to know a little bit of setting up on your server, either the Ajax or Nginx server. So you'll want to know a little bit of the technical side to set it up. So for most of us, the PHP version is fine. Once you select that, then we can click Save Changes. Once we've done that, we can go over to redirect. And this is where you want to set the old one and point it to the new one. And to show you what this looks like, we're going to go into some of my posts and just give you an example. Say, for instance, this was just a test, but it's starting to gather some traffic. So I actually want to redirect that to my complete guide to conversion. I'm just opening these up so I know what the address or what the URL is. I'm gonna copy that, go back to redirect, and you wanna set it up just like you see here. Paste that in there. Yep, that looks good. And then this is where I want to redirect it to. I'll copy that and let's go ahead and add that. We already have that as the default of the move permanently, so I'm okay with that. You'll start to see all of the redirects down here. For instance, I have this one as old and new. What I like about it is it tells you what type of redirect is it? Is Is it a manual or is it? What I also like is if I go in and make changes to the URL structure, it'll automatically come in here and create one for me. So for instance, do a new one, how to edit all together. So I want to go in here and say I want to change. I don't want to do ultimate. So I'm going to remove that, right? And when I update this, go back, and if I refresh, and so once that goes through, as you see here, you can also see how many hits. So how many people have gone to the old one and then have been redirected to the new one. You can also come over here, hover over it, and you can check the redirect. So I'm going to check this, and I'll try and go to the old one, and hopefully, yep, it takes it to the new one. So that's a perfect way for it to set up. The other thing is you can come under settings and you want to set up your 404 logs. So this is a great way to check your broken link. And I've created a whole tutorial on how to do this as well, different ways that you can check your broken links, and you can watch that as well. But you can set this up and you can choose how long to keep the logs. And what this will do is anytime somebody goes to a broken link, once you have this set up and once it's actually collected at least one, you can go to 404 logs and it will tell you all of the broken links that are out there. And do you want to add a redirect for this? So for instance, we just did this one. We created a broken link for that. So let's go ahead and click add redirect, and you need to decide where do you want it to go. Once you see the logs, you can see if you want to do anything with them, or you can get some more information, or you can just delete it. If you want to, you can add the redirect and send out the target link. I'm just going to send it to this one and add a redirect for that. Once that does that, you can go back to redirect, and we now have this new redirect here. The group is 404 because it's from the 404 logs, and then you can even check it. And then they also have full site redirect. So this is if you want to just relocate your entire site. We won't cover that in this one, but you can do that as well. Method 2 is another plugin that you can use. It is something called Redirection, and it's been around for years. You can go to Plugins, Add New, and then search for Redirection. And then this is the plugin that you want to do. So let's go ahead and install now. And then you want to stick around to activate the plugin as well. From here, we see it right here. You can go to Settings, or if you ever need to, just go to Tools, Redirection to set things up. You see how it's telling you a little bit of how to use it. We can just start the setup here. You want to monitor permalink changes for posts and pages, and you want to keep a log of all of them. You can also decide to store the IP information for redirects and 404s and enable all of that and continue the setup. And now it's going to go in and test everything, and we can say finish setup. And if you notice, WordPress automatically creates redirections when you change a post URL. And so if you import those into redirection, then you can manage them, monitor them here. So let's go ahead and do those old slugs to new slugs. That's fine. And here are some of the ones that we just had set up. And so if you ever need to come in here and make a redirection, you can put the old one here. You don't want to double these up, so you just want to do it one or the other. So we're going to do the old one and where we want to send it, and we'll add a redirect. And very similar to All-in-One SEO, it'll show you how many hits for, so you can see the hits, the last access, and you can also check the redirect to make sure everything is loading properly as expected, and it'll tell you yes or no. Okay, so sometimes you might want to not necessarily get rid of the link, but maybe you want to keep that post, but you want it to link to another one. Well, that's where this next one comes in. It's called Page Links To. And let me show you what that does. So if you go back to Plugins, Add New, you do Page Link To. Go ahead and install now and activate it as well. And now when you go into a post or a page, so if I go into the edit this, then we'll see a new area over here under post, and it says page links to. So do you want it to link to its normal post or its normal WordPress URL? No, let's go ahead and do a custom URL. And say we want that to link to our ultimate guide. We'll do that. You can choose if you want to open it in a new tab. See this in action. So I'll open this up. Complete guide for conversion tracking for WordPress. So remember I said it's the welcome to Gutenberg. When we view it, it goes to our complete guide. And number 4 is by using simple 301 redirects. Go back to Plugins, Add New, and we're looking for simple 301 redirect. Very similar to redirections, very similar to the All-in-One SEO. You can simply redirect, but that's like all it does. Whereas like All-in-One SEO, I think it just does a really good job of doing multiple things for you. So you can install it, you can activate it, and just like with redirection, you can go in and make your changes. So for here, we want to go to Settings, 301 redirects, and it's the same thing. Wherever it is, the old page to the new page, and with 301 redirects, simple 301 redirects, you just see all of them here. And then they have ways to upgrade if you want. Now, the final way to do this is you can set up 301 redirects using your HT access file. While using 301 redirect plugins are great, they can take a little bit of a hit on your server. And so sometimes you can use something like HT access file to add the redirect. And that's basically going right into your server using an FTP client to do a redirect. I'll have a link in the description below on the written way to do that. You can simply add it via FTP client, or you can also use All-in-One SEO. They have a way to go to All-in-One SEO, go to tools, and from there you have HT Access Editor. This is your editor on your server, so you could add that here. Do be careful, HT Access, if you create anything that you shouldn't, then you can definitely break your website and not be able to get into it. So make a backup, or web hosting providers like SiteGround or Bluehost, they're also great at, if you ask them to add this bit of code to your HT access, then they'll do that as well. Now that you've learned all about redirection, a lot of times it's about finding the broken links to add the redirection. Make sure you watch this video next as I walk you through how to find broken links, and we'll cover several different methods so you can pick the one that works best for you. And I'll see you over there.